Hello children, how are you? I hope you are all good and doing well. Welcome back to our science class. This is your science teacher. Children, how many members see the videos? Okay, very good children. Don't waste your time. Watch the videos and understood the topic. Okay, so many times I told you that after watching the video, you must need to read it. Textbook. So as early as possible, take the textbook, children. Okay? Children, in this video, once we revise the previous class, after that, we learnt about eating habits of birds and kinds of bees and feet and class of the birds. Okay, children? Once we revise the previous class. What we learnt in the previous class, children? Yes, very good. We learnt about birds. Okay, there are so many birds in this world and there are more than 8,000 kinds of birds. These are all we learnt in the previous class. And parts of a bird and what makes a bird to fly. What makes a bird able to fly and how does a bird fly. Next one, we learnt about different kinds of flights. Some birds fly very low. Some birds fly very high. Some birds fly high. Those are all and flightless birds and aquatic birds. These are all we learnt in the previous video. Okay, children. In this video, I continue the previous video. Okay, are you ready to learn? Very good. Once you see your textbook, children, this is your thoughtless textbook. Once you open the page number 45. Yesterday we learnt about different types of birds and birds flying, birds with different flights. These are all we learnt in the previous video. Now I explain kinds of beaks, eating habits of birds. These are all. See the page number 45, children. Once you see, this is the yes, eating habits of birds. Actually, basically, birds have no teeth to eat the food. Do you know, children? Birds have no teeth to eat the food. So, they have beaks and claws to catch the food and eat them. Yes or no, children? They have no teeth. So, they have a beak. Beak means? Yes, the nose of a bird is a beak. Beaks and claws. Claws means panja. Once you see your textbook, eating habits of a birds. Birds have no teeth to eat the food, but they have beaks, bills and claws to catch the food and eat it. Different kinds of birds have beaks and bills of different shapes and sizes. They also use their beaks and bills to protect themselves from enemies. Okay, children, birds have no teeth to eat the food, but they have a beak and a claw catch and eat the food. And they protect themselves from enemies also. Okay, children. See the next one. Kinds of beaks. All birds do not have the same type of beak. Different birds have different types of beaks. Okay. We learnt about different kinds of beaks. First one. Short, hard and horny beaks. Short, hard and horny beaks. Short means very small. Hard means very strong. Next one, horny. Horny means sharp. Okay, very sharp. Here, sparrows, pigeons, peacocks and finches have short, hard and horny beaks to crack nuts and seeds and eat them. Some birds like sparrow, pigeon, peacock and finches. You know that what is the meaning of sparrow, pigeon and peacock. Next one, finches. Have you ever listened this word, children? Finches. F-I-N-C-H-E-S, finches. Finches means it's one type of a bird. Finches means gorvanga. Have you ever listened that word? Yeah, very good. These birds have a short, hard and horny beaks. Short means very small beak. And next one, hard. It's very strong. And horny. Horny means very sharp. Very small beak, but very hard and very sharp also. Sparrows, pigeons and peacocks and finches have this type of beak. Once you observe the diagram, children, this is the Yeah, pigeon. Next one, sparrow. Next one, peacock. These birds have a short, hard, and horny beak. Okay, by using these beaks, the birds crack the seeds and eat them. Okay. Next, second one, strong, sharp, and hooked beaks. Strong, sharp, and hooked beaks. Here, strong means chala balamaina. Sharp, very sharp, podunaina. Mariyu, hooked beaks. Hooked is nothing but just carved children. Hooked is nothing but just carved. Just umpuga untai manmidu beaks. Eagles, owls, vultures, kites, and hawks have a strong, sharp, hooked, and curved beaks for tearing the flesh. These birds eat other animals like small birds, frogs, snakes, etc. Here, once you observe the diagrams, eagle, vulture, hawk, and owl. You know the meaning of eagle and vulture. So, hawk is nothing but. Did you know the Telugu meaning of hawk? Yeah, hawk means dagger. Next one, owl. You know that. These are all having strong, sharp, and hooked beaks. Very strong, sharp, and hooked means just curved. Once you observe the beaks of these birds, children, in the front, just curved. That is nothing but hooked beak. Okay, children, these have a strong, sharp, and curved beaks, hooked beaks. By using these beaks, they tear the flesh. They tear the flesh. Tear means like this. Tear, children. They tear the flesh and eat them. Okay, and what is the third kind, children? Once you see hooked beaks, some birds have only hooked beaks. Hooked means just only I told you that. Yes, curved. See, parrots. Parrots use their beaks and bills for cracking nuts and seeds from fresh fruits. They also use their beaks and bills to climb up. Parrots have a hooked beaks. Once you observe that beak of a parrot, children, here, just curved. Okay, this is the hooked beak. By using this curved beak, parrot eat the fruits and climb the trees also. Next one, strong and chisel shaped beak. Some birds have a strong and chisel shaped beak. Birds like woodpecker. Have you ever seen the woodpecker, children? Yeah, in the Discovery Channel also there are so many birds and animals there. Once you see the woodpecker. This is the woodpecker bird. Here, the woodpecker have a strong and chisel shaped beak. Woodpecker have a strong and chisel shaped beak. Strong means? Yes, it's very hard. And next one, chisel shaped. Very sharp. Chisel means very sharp. A woodpecker has a strong and chisel shaped beak to tap and make holes in the trees. Tree trunks and take out insects. Once you observe the beak of a woodpecker, children, very, very sharp, strong, and chisel shape. By using this beak, the woodpecker make the holes in the tree trunk and take insects from out. Okay, children, make the holes in the tree trunk and takes the insect from the tree trunk. Next one, long and slender beak. Long means podavaina, mari slender beak. Slender means thin. Sannanga undadani slender ante. Hoopoes have long and slender beaks to pull out insects from the flowers and holes in the ground. Here, hoopoes. Hoopoes means guava. Okay, children, hoopoe. Once you observe the spelling, children, H-O-O-P-O-E-S. Hoopoes. Once you observe the pronunciation also, hoopoes have a long and slender beak. Once you observe the picture, long and slender beak. To pull out insects from the flowers and holes in the ground. The hoopoes use their beak to pull out the insects from the flowers and holes in the ground. Okay? They make holes in the ground and take the insects and eat them. Next one, broad, long, and pointed beak. Broad, long, and pointed beak. Broad means width, very high width. Next one, here, kingfishers and cranes, with the help of broad, long, and pointed beaks, catch fish from rivers and ponds. Kingfishers, you know that, I think. long and pointed. The kingfisher used his beak to catch the fish from rivers and ponds. Okay. Next one, broad and short beak. Broad means width, that is fine. And short beak, very small beak. Swallows have broad and short beaks. It is sticky inside. Swallow goes around in the air, keeping its beak open. Tiny flying insects stick inside its mouth. Here, once you observe, children, this is a swallow bird. The bird name is swallow. The bird have a broad and short beak. Broad and short beak, once you observe. And the bird have a sticky tongue. Swallow goes around in the air, keeping its beak open. And automatically the insects are attached to the beak. Why? Because it have a sticky inside. Sticky means jigtega. Okay? That's why the insects are attached to its beak. This is the specialty of swallow. Once you see the next one, broad and flat beak. Broad and flat beak. Ducks have broad and flat beaks. The beak has a tiny holes at the sides. The duck takes muddy water with worms, insects and water plants. Water and mud go out through the holes. Plants and insects are left in the mouth to swallow. Here the ducks. Ducks have a broad and flat. Broad means better and flat. Chala chodunuga undadi. Duck. Once you observe the beak of a duck, it's very broad and flat. Here, the duck takes the muddy water with their beaks. And in the muddy water, so many insects, worms are there. The duck takes the water and mud, go through the holes. Plants and insects are left in the mouth to swallow. Here, the duck takes the muddy water, and in the muddy water, there are so many worms and insects also there. The duck eats the worms and insects and leaves the mud and water throughout. Okay, children? These are the different types of beaks. The birds have different types of beaks. Some birds have short, pointed and horny beaks, and some birds have only hooked beaks. And some birds have broad and flat beaks. These are all the different kinds of beaks. Okay. Next, we learnt about feet and claws. Feet and claws. A bird has two legs. Each leg has a four toes. As you know that, bird has a two legs. Every bird has a two legs. And each leg has a four toes. Okay. At the tip of the toe, there is a nail or claw. Different birds have different types of claws. The claws help the birds in catching, holding and eating food. They protect the birds from their enemies. Okay, every bird has a two legs and every leg has a four toes. At the tip of the toe, there is a claw. There is a claw. Nail or claw. And these birds, different types of birds, different types of birds have a different types of claws, and these birds uses the claws to catch the food and holding to eat the food also. Once we know about different types of claws, just now only we learned about different types of beaks. Now we want to learn about different types of claws. First one is flesh eaters. The birds which eat the flesh, they have a something different type of claws. Which type of claws they have? Once we learn. First one, flesh eaters. Flesh eating birds like hawks, kites, owls and vultures have strong and sharp claws. They help to catch and carry away live prey like toads, frogs, rats and small birds. Here, flesh eating birds have a sharp and strong claws. Once you observe the claws, children. Claws means this. At the tip of the toe, there is a claw. Okay. The claws are very strong and sharp because they are the flesh eaters. They eat the flesh by catching the flesh with these claws and prey. Here you Observe them. This one, children, pray. P R E V. There is a difference between P R E V and P R E V. P R E V is nothing but food. Okay, ahar. Next one, scratches. Domestic birds like hens and cocks scratch the air with their claws for worms and seeds. They have three long toes in front and one short toe at the back. These toes have sharp and hard claws to dig the earth. Okay, children. Scratchers. Scratching means just like they have a claws. By using the claws, they take the mud with the claws. Scratching means goal to get and scratching under. Some birds scratch with their nails. Like domestic birds like hens and cocks scratch the earth with their claws for worms and seeds. In your daily life, you observe that in your homes also hens and cocks are there. They scratch the earth with their claws for small worms or insects. They have three long toes in front and one short toe at the back. These toes have a sharp and hard claws to dig the earth. The scratchers have three toes in front and one toe is at the back. Okay, they have a strong claws to dig the earth for insects and worms. Okay, children. See the next one, third one, patches. What is the children? Patching means it's nothing but if you take a bird belongs to a patching. Birds like crows, sparrows, mynas patch on the branches of a trees. They have four toes, three in front and one at the back. These toes help the bird to hold the branch firmly. These birds even go to sleep by patching. Okay, children. Here, birds like crows, sparrows, and mynas pitch on the branches. Pitching means just a pachi vaaladaniki kavalsina aadharanni pitching antaru. They have four toes, three in front, one at the back. The pitchers have four toes, three in front and one at the back. It is easy to catch the branch of a tree. Okay. Here once you observe, these birds even go to sleep while pitching. Sometimes while pitching, these birds go to sleep. Next one, climbers. Birds like parrots and woodpeckers climb up trees. Parrots and woodpeckers climb up the trees. They have two toes pointing upwards and two pointing downwards. With the help of these toes, they can climb up and cling the bark of the tree. Okay, children. Here once you observe the climbers toys, there are two in front and two in back. Okay, they have the strong claws. They use it to climb up the trees and sometimes cling. Cling means wallet. Next one, swimmers. Water birds like ducks and swans have a waterproof feathers and webbed toys. They have oil glands in their skin to keep the feathers waterproof. These birds have three front toes and one at the back. The three front toes are joined together by skin webs in between. The skin helps to push back water while swimming. Already in the previous video, we learned about water birds, children. Water birds have a webbed toes. Webbed means there is a skin between the toes. Once you observe like this. Again, the skin, the webbed toes helps the birds to swim in the water. They have a webbed toes. Webbed means nothing but it's very easy. There is a skin between the toes. Once you observe the diagram, you clearly understood. There is a skin between the toes, that is webbed. And the webbed, the swimmers also have three front toes and one is at the back and strong claws also. Their webbed toes helps the swimmers to swim in the water. Examples are ducks, swans, cranes are the examples. Okay. Next one, waders. Waders are also water birds. Waders are also a water birds. They wade through muddy water, ponds, river and sometimes even the sea. Waders have a long legs and thin outspreading toes. These thin toes never get caught in the mud. Their long legs keep their body above the level of water. Cranes, herons, egrets and pipers etc. are waders. Once you observe the words, children, cranes, herons, egrets and pipers are the waders. Okay, these are all the cranes. You know that Pongalo. Herons, egrets are the also the cranes. It belongs to the cranes family. It's and pipers. These are all the one type of waders. These are the these are also the water birds, and they walk above the water on the river, on the pond, and on the sea also. These are called waders. Okay, children. The last one is runners. The ostrich is a runner. It has very strong and long legs for running. It has only two toes. These heavy cushion like toes do not sink into the desert sand as it runs fast. Okay, children. The runners. Ostrich is an example for runner. The ostrich is a runner. It has very strong and long legs. Strong and long legs for running. In the it has only two toes. The ostrich. Ostrich has only two toes, but it do not sink into the desert sand as it runs fast. In the sand also, it runs very fast. So that's why it is called a runner. Okay, children. Ostrich has a runner. It has only two toes, but it does not sink into the desert or sand. So it runs very fast. So it is called a runner. Remember that. Okay, children. It was completed. I hope you would have understood the topic. Once I revise what we learnt in this class. Eating habits of birds. Some birds, birds have no teeth to eat the food. So, but they have beaks and claws to eat the food, to catch and eat the food. So, we learnt about different kinds of beaks and different types of beaks and claws of a birds. Okay, children. Once you buy a textbook and read the textbook, then you understand very clearly. Children, for your understanding, I use a little bit of Telugu words for your more understanding. Okay, children, thank you for watching the video.